This video is intended to introduce the notion of function composition. Now we know that when we have a domain and range and some element in the domain, it can be mapped to an element in the range by some function f, and we might call that output f of x. So f maps x to f of x from the domain to the range. Now what if we have another set? And now what was our range is now our domain, and this new set is our range. Then we might have some other function taking f of x, which is now an element in our domain, to an element in our new range. Let's call that function g. So our output now is g of f of x. So we have a two-step process. F mapped x to f of x, and g mapped f of x to g of f of x. What a composition does is turn that into a single step that has a domain, which is the domain of f, and a range, which is the range of g, and we call that g of f of x. And that's basically what a composition does. With two functions, it turns that two-step process into a one-step process. We can actually compose functions as many times as we want, as long as the range of the function is in the domain of the function it's being put into.